in the interest of time, we're going to skip the first fight, but instead we're going to do the first fight verbally only. So you're going to start with down with Montagues, down with Capulets, and I'm going to quiet you. And as I do, you'll get down, but you'll get down scattered like this, so you won't actually engage in fight. So as we're going, here we are, and we're walking around the space. The music is underneath us somewhere, dun, 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 right? It's going on. And as it's happening, you guys start to see people out there, and somebody might start off by saying, down with Montague. It's going to, yeah, down with Capulets.
Down with Capulets.
Down with Capulets.
Down with Capulets. Down with Capulets. Down with Capulets. Down with Capulets. Down with Capulets.
If ever you disturb these streets again, your lives shall pay the forfeit of the peace. If ever you disturb these streets again, your lives shall pay the forfeit of the peace. Once more, on pain of death, depart! And there's a party going on tonight. Good, good, good. And when you're ready, find yourselves back into your lines. And as you're in your lines, see the people across from you, and you know that this is a person that you hate, but you're still going to step in, present arms, and dance.
Dun, 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 dun. Go the other way. Dun, 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 dun.
And as you get to the side, here we go. And present arms, engage, and fight. Down with Montagues. Down with
Montagues.
And then from in the midst of all of this, Romeo stands on one side, and Juliet stands on the other side, and Romeo says,
"It is my lady. Oh, it is my love."
And Juliet says,
"My only love sprung from my only hate."
And Tybalt steps out.
"Thou art a villain."
And Mercutio steps out.
"Tybalt, you rat catcher, will you walk?"
And of course he will. "Come on, Tybalt. Come on, Mercutio. Come on, Mercutio. Come on, Mercutio. Come on, Mercutio. Come on, Mercutio.
Mercutio.
Turn around. Kill him. Ah, falls down dead. Strike your staff. Don't worry about that's with the plague. Or thus, plague on both your houses.
A plague on both your houses.
Good. Strike your staff. Good. Step on. Good. Falls down dead. Good. Just as Lord and Lady Montague, Lord and Lady Capulet step out, they see what's going on. Oh my gosh. Friar comes out.
Romeo, thou art banished.
Romeo is banished. He goes off to Padua. Balthazar stands up. He's about to go. Juliet's desperate. She goes off to the friar. Balthazar sees that happening and comes over. The friar gives her a potion. She runs to the tomb. She takes the potion. He dies. Balthazar knows what's going on. He's gonna go tell Romeo. Off he goes to tell Romeo. He tells, "Oh no, this is terrible." Here he comes. Slow down, slow down. The apothecary steps out. Yes, poor Lady Montague is dead. Comes out. "Please, no, please." "Oh, all right." Gives him the poison. He makes his way around this tree. Comes over and sees Paris, who's gonna block his way. Paris calls out to the authorities, and he kills him. Ah, another person dead. Comes into the tomb. Makes his way over to sweet Juliet. Juliet's lying dead on the floor. Juliet, you see her, you take her hand. Take the poison.
That's with the kiss. I die.
He dies. Juliet wakes up. Ah, feels pretty good. Oh, wait a second. Oh, no.
"Come, happy dagger. This is thy sheath. Rest here and let me die."
Good. Falls down dead. In come the Capulets and the Montague, the one remaining Montague. They look across to the friar, who knows that it's his fault, and he says,
"A greater power than we can contradict has thwarted our intent."
And then the prince steps forward and speaks to the frozen scene that is everybody here and to the audience and said,
"See what a scourge is laid upon your hate, that heaven finds means to kill your joys of love. A glooming peace this morning with it brings. The sun for sorrow will not show his head. Go hence to have more talk of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned and some punished. For never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo."